Welcome, everybody. Yesterday we had an FOMC statement, and that is why we are talking with Davide Biocchi, trader from Directa via Skype. Hello, Davide.
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm very well. How are you?
Doing good, thank you.
Okay, Davide, what can you say about yesterday's FOMC statement? What did they do with interest rates?
Well, the situation was more or less, let me say, nothing special in a certain way, because they said that they will know no more, let me say, in an incoming future, change the interest rates, and that the board was unanimous to take the decision. So this is what exactly the market expected to know. And as it happened for the ECB bank 1 week ago, we can say something like this was a known event. I mean, consider that I'm sitting in front of a market every day since 22 years, and it's very rare. It's not something that often happens, that during the press conference of the Federal Reserve director, the euro-dollar the euro-dollar currency exchange is moving up and down in 10 pips. This is really thin. This is really no volatility. So this means that yesterday's announcement was a known event. The market is now looking at something different, not the central bank in these 2 weeks.
Okay, so the question is, what the market is looking for right now at the moment?
Well, just before doing that, let's say that if you can see here, the market tested again the 1.10, let me say, support on the euro dollar, and we can be more precise. Exactly, it is 109.80 and something, but to be, let me say, not so precise, we can say that the market is moving up and down within two figures, from 110 to 112, up and down here, okay? And this is quite strange, because if we go back in years, we have never seen the possibility for the euro dollar to remain in such a thin, let me say, and sideways market for a long time. Okay, the market are now focused on something different, that is the coronavirus. Coronavirus is really impacting a lot in China, and this is exactly connected to the fear of that this morning we have a gap down in the stocks market. Some sellings are coming, and also the bond, the yield of the bond went down. So this means that people don't want to invest. They park the money into the bond, and they pay for that because they do not want to invest. Okay, I think this is clear. So generally, investors are scared, and they do not want to take decisions right now. So what we have here is that we have an environment that is coming from a very risk-on, open-minded to get to take risks. Okay. But now this situation is impacted by this coronavirus that we do not really know about the effects. Some economists are doing calculation, but they are not precise. They are, let me say, they are saying something like maybe China can lose between 1.5 to 4%, but this is an incredible difference. So it's not easy to see which can be the proper price for the markets. And in this case, people say, okay, I will park my money there. Even if it costs a little, later I will decide. I think you understand what I mean.
Yes, but what do you think about this whole situation with coronavirus? You said that it has a very strong impact now on the markets. But do you think that maybe there will be some possibilities for example, for a long trade on gold, or maybe for some risk off movement on Swiss or maybe on yen?
Well, that could be. But in a certain way, I mean, the first thing we have to look at is the crude oil. because the crude oil is the commodity more impacted by this crisis. And that's why we have seen through the last days that the price came down and we can easily say collapsed very close to the support of 50. The support of 50 is a very, very important support, because under that, also for some technical reasons connected to options activity, we can probably see a sell-off if the price will go down, probably to the previous minimum around $43 per barrel. But this is something we do not know if it will happen. But for sure, in my layout, I always have a crude oil, not only because I like trading the crude oil, but because it gives me a perspective of the environment that we will see in all the asset classes. Okay, so this is very, very important. Second thing is that we can clearly see that people who bought the gold never sold it. So what happened was that now we can say that the jump of the gold started in last spring. Okay, there was a breakout here and the market going up here. Okay, what happened was that again we have something like consolidation in the market, then again a jump, consolidation, a jump, another consolidation, and then another jump. We are very close to the resistance that is at 1,610. Over this level, the market remained a really long time ago in a trading range between 1,600 to 1,800. So I suppose that if we will overtake 1,600, we'll change the entire environment on gold. And what is interesting is that even when the risk-on situation went on for a long time between the last years and the very beginning of this one, no one that bought the gold exit the gold. So this is really something that we must think on.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that it's very interesting. And yeah. What do you think? You told us about euro dollar. You told us also about crude oil and gold. And if you could only look at the silver, because everybody say that silver is a very interesting instrument. And it looks like it's quite weaker than gold. It's not that popular as gold, but also it has a much more potential on the long trend.
It is very good for trading. Normally, it follows sometimes what happens on the gold, but in this moment can be again also with the copper also. Another indicator about the economy, because imagine that silver, copper, gold too, especially oil, they are used to produce. Okay, so if we will see something like a stop in activity, because imagine this, imagine that in China nowadays more than 60 million of people are in quarantine. Okay, it means that they are more than all the Polish. I think you are around 40 million, okay?
Yes.
Italians are 60 million, so they are like Italy, all in quarantine. And imagine that in a case like this, it's easy to understand. Imagine that people will buy no bread, no milk, no supermarket. Public and private transportation can stop and close. Nobody's moving. Nobody's thinking about spending holidays, spending weekends. So the economy is really like collapsing, like a terrible brake, you know, in a car. So, and it's not easy even after to put the engine on and start again. This is not something that can happen automatically. I think you understand. So that's why we must see the impact. And to see the impact, all these commodities, not only silver, are very important. So silver, copper, crude oil, as commodities that are used in the production chain, okay? On the other side, we have the gold that is not only used, but is always known as an asset class where investors put money when they are scared. Okay, so this is the situation, and this is the intermarket, let me say, asset classes allocation that is very interesting.
Yes, okay. Davide, thank you very much for this conversation. Straight from Italy, Davide Biocchi, trader, director. Thank you very much.
Ciao, ciao, see you soon.
See you soon.